Alrighty, welcome to a legacy video here on ChannelFireball.com. We've got lands today. 36 lands in the main deck, another one on the sideboard for value. This deck's pretty sweet. It has won a lot in legacy despite having a lot of lands and a very weird game plan. Let me try to break it down. This is a Life from the Loam deck. That's the most important card in the deck. And in fact, the reason you play Gamble is to get Life from the Loam. Though, funnily enough, you actually want to discard the Loam most of the time when you gamble on turn one because you can then dredge it back. So this deck is designed to assemble a bunch of different combos, all of which kind of revolve around Loam. And then you have one copy of Mana Bond, which lets you just dump all your lands into play, and four Explorations, which lets you play additional land, plus four Crop Rotation, which lets you tutor up lands. You can play Punishing Fire from the graveyard. You've got four copies of Grove of the Burn Willows, make your opponent gain a life, get Punishing Fire back. And then you have a bunch of different land packages. The headliner is Thespian Stage plus Dark Depths, and the way this combo works is you have a Dark Depths in play, it's got 10 ice counters. You copy it with Thespian Stage, choose to keep the stage since the land is legendary. Now you have a Dark Depths with zero ice counters, and ba-bam, 2020, Black Avatar creature token with flying. You also have a bunch of one-of lands to tutor for. Well, two Mazes of Ith, which untap an attacking creature, keep creatures off your back. The Tabernacle at Pendril Veil, the most expensive card in the deck in paper, though it's like $3 here online, which gives all creatures an upkeep of one. Glacial Chasm, which a lot of text, but basically means you don't take damage, and though you pay two life a turn, or two life, then four life, then six life, as cumulative upkeep works, you can just keep sacrificing this and then using Life from the Loam to get it back, as long as you have an exploration to play multiple lands. Horizon Canopy has a cycling land from play, along with Sheltered Thicket, another cycling land, though this is from hand, and Tranquil Thicket, so lots of cycling. Cycling Life from the Loam is a good combo. You loam back, like, say, Tranquil Thicket, plus two other lands, cycle the thicket, dredge the loam, loam again, and just kind of go off from there. Taiga has your red-green land alongside Grove, a couple fetch lands, then four wastelands. Ignore the off-picture wasteland. Four wastelands and four ghost quarters to mess with your opponent's mana. And a couple basic forests. You also have four Mox Diamonds, which really let you pop when you have them in your opening hand. Sideboard, you got Molten Vortex and Drop of Honey against creatures. A lot of cards against combo, because this deck's pretty bad against non-interactive combos. Four Sphere of Resistance, two Trinisphere, and then an Ancient Tomb to make them come out faster. Crows and Grip to kill, well, enchantments or artifacts that could disrupt you, and then some Tireless Trackers against control decks. All right, let's take this for a spin. I'm in a queue. I'm currently 1-0 in this league. I took it for one practice game, and now we're battling for real. Alrighty, am I gonna keep this hand? Oh yes, this hand is great. We've got turn one, double Mox Diamond, and Life from the Loam, and then land exploration. Ooh, and we're playing against blue decks. One of the reasons you want to play lands is to play against blue decks. So Mother Rune's interesting. Well, I still like this hand, so let's go. How do I want to do this? I'm going to play both diamonds. The question is, I want to play exploration as well, so why don't I really don't want to get dazed. So let's go. Yeah, okay, this works. Taiga, Mox Diamond, discard forest. Exploration. Please don't Force of Will me, though Mother Runes and Force of Will don't often go in the same deck. Neither does Daze, honestly, but I can play around it basically for free. I think this is the best draw I've seen lands get, though. What I dredge with this Loam, I guess, will change that some. Turn one, Wasteland you, Exploration, double Mox Diamond, Loam. And now it doesn't matter if they have counter magic. If they counter Life from Loam, sure, I'll just dredge it next turn. So this is extremely sweet. This is, well, I wouldn't say this is why you play the deck, because this draw is a once in a blue moon kind of draw, but we are doing just fine here. Weather Wayfarer, they can go get their own lands. All right, well, I'm going to dredge Life from Loam. I flipped a Glacial Chasm and a Gamble. Not really what I'm looking for. Let's go ahead and Wasteland. They can Weather Wayfarer all they want, and then get my three lands back. And because I have Exploration and Glacial Chasm, if I need to, I can end up in a spot where I just replay Glacial Chasm every turn, though. I'm not too worried about that right now. My opponent does not have much of a fighting force in play. Let's see. So playing against some kind of Bant Humans deck. Oh, Death and Taxes with blue and green, who knows. Ooh, there's a Punishing Fire and a Horizon Canopy, so no lands yet. I could, yeah, there's no point in using Wasteland or Ghost Quarter. I could play Glacial Chasm, I guess, but I really don't care about this 2 points of damage, so I'm just gonna get back Horizon Canopy. I'm gonna play Horizon Canopy as my land. I'm gonna sack it to draw a card and dredge Life from the Loam. And there we go, Dark Depths, Grove of the Burn Willows, Horizon Canopy. Oh, I guess I should probably play my land. I'll play Ghost Quarter because I have access to lots of green. Oh, that's not a Horizon Canopy. Well, they're super dead. It doesn't really matter what they do at this point, barring them like having random Bojuka Bogs or something because they have Weathered Wayfarer in their deck. Don't really know what's going on over there. Okay, there's an island. Could probably Ghost Quarter their island away anyway. All right, let's dredge Loam. Sure, let's Ghost Quarter you. This does give them access to 2 mana. They can tap the island for mana and get a basic and then play something. But another island. Don't know what's going on here. I'm going to sack this to draw a card. I guess I want a Loam first. Oh, there's a Mazebith. Let's just play Mazebith then to stop their things and get back Ghost Quarter, Horizon Canopy, and Verdant Catacomb. I'm not really worried about getting back Punishing Fire because they have Mother Runes in play right now. And pass the turn. Oh, I guess I let them float mana. Brainstorm, huh? Okie dokie. I'm just going to discard Forest, I guess. Let's see. Tundra. We will probably be wasting that one soon. They could also use Weathered Wayfarer at this point. Worth noting. Draw Dredge Loam. Oh, there's a Thespian Stage. All right, let's get Thespian Stage, Tranquil Thicket. All right, they've had enough. I mean, against that deck, I would be inclined to bring in Drop of Honey, but I don't really know what's going on in Molten Vortex. I mean, Tireless Tracker is also an option if they're playing like some kind of blue controlish deck. Bojuka Bog's pretty bad. You can also side out some of the lands just because, well, you don't need the lands like this that don't. They're more for the effect. Bojuka Bog, you can tutor for with crop rotation as your graveyard hate. I don't even know if I want Drop of Honey, honestly. I don't really know what's going on. I'm just going to put a Molten Vortex in for now and maybe bring in some Tireless Trackers or Crozen Groups depending on what kind of disruption my opponent seems to have. All right, what do we got? Yeah, this hand is fine. I could use a Mox Diamond or an Exploration just as a bit of acceleration. But it has Gamble for Life and Loam, which is nice. The Mother Runes, which does very little against this deck. I don't really know what's going on over there, but I think I'm just going to lead by Wasteland and slowing us both down and giving myself more time to draw into one of the lands or acceleration pieces I'm looking for. Let's just play Catacombs, and I guess I could just gamble now. This is fine. Get Taiga, cast Gamble. Am I getting Spell Pierced? Or are they brainstorming response? Dazed. Okay. Them getting set back a turn is also fine with me. I've got some Cycler, so I can do some things. I can at some point crop rotation. I'm also setting up a pretty potential fast Aether Vial. Okay, this makes more sense. But all the islands don't. I really don't know what's going on over there yet, honestly. Let's just play Thespian Stage and pass. I'm going to cycle Sheltered Thicket because it costs more to cycle. Might as well get my mana value here. And then I'm fairly close to crop rotating into Dark Depths and just going off from there. So I want to save the ability to do that. Wasteland and my Taiga. Actually, I could crop rotate in response because it. But I don't think. No, I'm just going to cycle. I don't really think I care about that. Like, the cost of crop rotating is not big because I have tons of lands, and I want to get Dark Depths, but I don't want to get it now. I'd rather get it later. There's a Life in the Loam. I don't mind that. Okay. I don't mind getting Wastelanded either. Let's get our last Taiga here. Life in the Loam back. Wasteland, Taiga, Sheltered Thicket. And if they counter Life in the Loam, yeah, I don't really care. I've got land drops to make. And so what's their best play? Like Violin Athalia or something to make it so my Life in the Loam costs a little bit more to use? Who knows? Let's dredge Loam. Ooh, a Tabernacle. All right, well, let's get back Tabernacle, Dark Depths, and Wasteland. And we're just going to play Tabernacle this turn. Tabernacle at Pendril Veil is just a very stupid card, honestly. Like, this card's just utter nonsense. Making your opponent pay one for every creature they control. Now they're going to put in Jace? Okay, well, they get to keep one of those three creatures. Yeah, good luck, I guess. I don't know how Aether Vial is going to change that. Oh no, I guess they get to keep two of them because they get to flip Jace. Never mind. They discarded another Aether Vial. So I'm playing as like blue-white humans. Or whatever you want to call it. Death and Taxes. I don't know. The Weather Wayfarer for a Wasteland. That is not going to do the trick against my Life in the Loam, I don't think. Alright. And let's see, so they're gonna play a Wasteland maybe? Plus Jace, sure. Gonna waste my Taiga and hope to get me on green, maybe? I don't know. I'm actually not gonna dredge because I'd rather draw, well, wouldn't rather draw that, but because I can always just Tranquil Thicket for, I was just hoping to draw Exploration or Mox Diamond. I'm not in a huge hurry. Let's cycle Tranquil Thicket and let's still not dredge. I drew another land, surprisingly. And let's just play a Wasteland. No, let's just play a Forest. We'll leave up a crop rotation here. Like, if they Vial in a 2-drop and then Wasteland Tabernacle, I think I'm actually going to crop rotate Tabernacle. I already have Adepts, I already have Stage. Could get Maze of Ith. That seems like kind of anemic. I could get Wasteland. Yeah, that's actually fine. And I don't think I'm going to Wasteland their land. We'll see what they Vial in, I suppose. Stoneforge Mystic. Okay, let's see what they search up. They get a Batterskull. I mean, I can stop them from putting Batterskull into play, but I actually don't even care too much to do that, so they can tick up their Jace, they can Ponder. Ooh, I guess I could have stopped them from Pondering by killing their land. They wouldn't have been able to do anything. No land and swing for one. Okay, I can Dark Depths them now if I want. Given they didn't play a land this turn, 19. Yeah, let's get back Loam. And I milled nothing. So I could Tabernacle them here. I could also just Dark Depth them. Let's just do that. So I'm not going to use it yet because they have to play a Wasteland in order for me to stop me. What I want to do is just pass and Wasteland their land. Ooh, what is this? What is your 3-drop? The Goose? Okay. This is fine. So I think during their second main phase, I'm probably gonna Wasteland them. Well, depends what they have untapped. I basically don't want them to be able to float mana and save their Ensorcerer's Plowshare as my Dark Depths token. And the reason I don't want a main phase Depths is that I didn't want to get Jace minus. All right, so they should be dead now. Copy Dark Depths. And there we go. All right, we survived our first round with lands. On to round two. Alrighty, welcome to round two. Currently 1-0 though, 2-0 in this league, no big deal. On the draw and our opponent's mulling, I actually think we mull two. The triple Dark Depths is pretty bad and I don't even have red for gamble, so seems not great. I will keep this hand, looking for a gamble or a life from the loam, but I do have double wasteland ghost quarter to mess with my opponent's mana beforehand. And let's see. Also, if my opponent scries to the top, turn one ghost quarter you. Taste it. Ooh, Dark Depths. I'm actually going to keep this on top. It's not a loam or a Mox Diamond or any of those things or a gamble, but it's a combo card for Thespian Stage, so I actually think it's worth keeping. Oh man, this is just great justice. Is this why we play lands? No, but this is just a bonus. All right, let's see what we do here. I guess it's worth playing Misty, I think. Our opponent got a basic, so I can't wasteland them. I'm not just snapping off Ghost Quarter on them. I need to know a little bit more about what they're playing first. Bloodstained Mire. All right. I'm just going to sack. I'm not worried about opposing wastelands, and I'd rather not draw Taiga here. All right. Ooh, Exploration. I like that. All right, let's play Exploration. Play Wasteland. Play Ghost Quarter. The reason I'm not playing Stage or Depths is I'd rather play them both in the same turn to play around opposing wastelands. Not that I think my opponent has those cards in their deck, given their two lands. Like, my opponent could be playing Storm here, though they're more likely to play Duress or Cabal Therapy than Thoughtseize. And they could be playing some kind of like mono black disruption deck. And we'll see what they've got. But I'm going to make a Dark Depth end of turn. And I didn't Ghost Quarter them now because if they played a Wasteland, I would want to keep Wasteland up. And if I used Ghost Quarter, I wouldn't have enough mana. Yeah, this looks like some kind of like smallpox deck. Yeah, Scrubland. This is like... Uh-oh. Well, that's not great. It looks like a reanimator deck. Okay. Well, given that I have Dark Depths Thespian Stage out, it's not impossible that they don't have a good reanimation target to fetch here. Like, I don't even know that, like, animating a Gristlebrand will do the trick. I mean, we'll see. This is like Tin Fins, I guess. And they're gonna maybe try to go off this turn, but they already played a land. So they have to hit like Lotus Petals and Rituals and stuff. And they get 14 cards to do it in. I mean, that's a lot of cards, I suppose. I guess the other thing is, even if they don't hit, I can make a Dark Depths end of turn and they get to block with Gristlebrand, which is kind of unfortunate. So, let's see. They're tanking on 9 life, which is interesting. They might be wondering if I have like Punishing Fire Unmask. Okay, well, still have nothing. So they're just going to pay the life now, presumably, unless they found everything they needed to go off already, which seems unlikely, but I suppose it's possible. All right, there's a Chromox and... Let's see what they've got here. Something like Children of Corliss, I think, is the card that lets them get all their life back and then draw the rest of their deck. That's one white for a 1/1. You sack it, you gain as much life as the amount of life you've lost this turn. So in this particular case, it will be a gain 15. Okay, they pitched Animate Dead to the Chrome Mox. They're Dark Ritualing. Sure. Yeah, I feel pretty dead. Tidespout Tyrant, huh? Exhumed Tidespout Tyrant, okay. Whenever you cast a spell, return target permanent to its owner's hand. Okay, they have Lotus Petal, and they're going to bounce the Dark Depths. For the Thespian Stage, I suppose. I feel like it's not going to work out to make a Dark Depths here. Like, there's just no way they don't have something to cast off this Lotus Petal. So we're going to let that pass. Get unmasked, sure. And maybe they're done with the nonsense? Who knows? And what could I draw? I suppose... No, Maze of Ith doesn't do it because they get to bounce it. It depends on really how many spells they have left to use with the Tidespout Tyrant. I assume it's a lot. Faithless Looting, okay. Sure. And I'm not sure what all I'm looking for next turn. But I don't like the position I'm in. Discarded Chancellor of the Annex and Sire of Insanity. Alright. I mean, I assume I'm dead, but I'm just going to play my two things, and I guess I'll even Wasteland. Oh, I was not even supposed to Wasteland. Whatever. I was just dead. They play two spells and I lose. So the question is, do you side in like all of this nonsense? The thing is, like, Punishing Fires don't do anything. And Caracas is actually fine. Bojuka Bog is good. What else am I supposed to side here? The Ghost Quarters seem a little less effective, given that we are playing against... Oh, Glacial Chasm seems horrendous. Ghost Quarters seem a little less effective, given that they have a lot of swamps in their deck, or presumably do. And I suppose at that point I will take out a Mana Bond as well. All right, we'll try this. I could play Crozen Grip, I guess. It is a little expensive. I suppose Crozen Grip is nice because they have Animate Deads, and you get to kill the Animate Dead in response to the trigger, but leaving that much mana up seems not great. All right, I would like to play first. Oh, yes. Wow, this hand is good. This is turn one Trinisphere. The revealed Chancellor of the Annex? Okay. I even have the extra Mox. No big deal. Discard Grove, play land, play Trinisphere. So turn one, opponent, every spell costs 3. So then now I get to gamble for Life from the Loam and start playing Life from the Loams. Actually, I think I want to play my land because I'd rather discard Life from the Loam. Funnily enough. Life from the Loam, and we discard it. Sweet. And then maybe lock our opponent out with like Wastelands or something. Well, I guess it's going to be hard to lock them out with Wastelands when they have those. All right, let's Loam. I could play Sphere of Resistance here, but it doesn't stack with Trinisphere the way you want. So I'm just going to Loam back some stuff and I'll play Thespian Stage and I'll pass the turn. And next turn I can dredge loam and then play sphere if I want to. They're also restricted to one spell per turn. It's going to be really hard to play more than one. Basically, if they want to play a 2-mana spell with Trinisphere and Sphere Resistance play, it costs 3, it doesn't cost 4. So. Alright, let's get Dark Depths and Ghost Quarter back. Yeah. And I'm going to leave up Caracas and Ghost Quarter rather than play Sphere of Resistance. I think I would rather leave up Caracas. I don't know how many basics this deck plays. They're going to entomb end of turn, presumably, and then try to untap and animate. And Sphere doesn't stop that. Alright, let's let them entomb. I guess I'm going to Ghost Quarter them. What's their entomb target that's sick here? Like, Tide's Pet Tyrant doesn't do anything. Gristlebrand doesn't do that much. I mean, I guess Tide's Pet Tyrant isn't a legendary creature, but... Do I want to Ghost Quarter them? I feel like I don't. Because next turn I'm going to play Dark Depths. I guess I just don't have to dredge Loam. Sure, I'll Ghost Quarter them. Oh, they only had 2 swamps. Okay, that's good to know. All right. Well, that is pretty decent. And so then I can just play Dark Depths, and my opponent can cast one spell with Tyrant in play, but certainly can't cast more than one. Oh, Crimson Grip is bad, too, because they have Exhum. And Exhum does not... Oh, they don't even have a way to get it back? Okay, yeah, they're in trouble then. All right, they are dead. Definitely don't want Tireless Trackers. I don't... Ghost Quarter's Drop of Honey. This does not seem good. They can just bounce it. Mana Bond on the draw? No, we sided into much more spells, so we'll try this. Maybe we'll get another turn on Trinisphere. Ooh, I like this hand. Not only do I have crop rotation for Bajuka Bog, I also just have a very fast kill with turn on exploration. Actually, I can turn on exploration, crop rotate for Dark Depths. I can actually, if I want, play a turn 2 Merit Lodge token. Opponent is mulliganing to 6. So. Depending on how they start, they kept 6. So I think what I just do is go, assuming I don't get Thoughtseize, you know, or Unmasked, Taiga Exploration. Oh, well, that actually changes things too. There's no reason not to, actually there is, never mind. There is a reason not to cast another Exploration here, and that reason is that I want to keep up crop rotation in case they entombed here. They did not, and they didn't play anything there either. Sure, let's just get a Taiga. Thespian Stage. And then now I might as well explore, because Grove taps for green if I need it to. Though I suppose it puts them to 21, which means that they don't die to Merit Lodge, but I think I'm going to be okay. This is a pretty sick line here. Let's crop rotate. Tap for a colorless, pay a green. Crop rotate, sacking this. I'm just assuming they don't have Force of Will in their deck. And Dark Depths. Thespian Stage, the Dark Depths. And I even have the backup combo if they somehow did something. This is a silly combo, I will give you that. This isn't, there's no way, it's kind of hard to argue. My opponent said, nice luck. Yes, it was nice luck. Thank you very much. That's round two. Let's see if we can continue going. Alrighty, we are 2-0 so far in the video, but I keep reminding you, 3-0 in the league, because I got to get that extra credit. Let's play this, and woohoo, we will keep this hand. It is nice. Turn one, loam. And the question is, what do we play and what do we discard? My inclination here is to... Let's see. So it's a big fan. Cool, cool. Good luck, good luck. Since this provides green, I don't need... I don't really have like a strong reason to lead with any particular thing. Let's lead with the Mox Diamond. I kind of don't want to show them Wasteland. So I think I'm going to run it this way. Because I'm not going to need to Wasteland twice on turn one. And I don't need Thespian Stage in play yet. I mean, they're going to play around Wasteland if they can. And some decks just can't. But the only thing that's different about any of the lands I play or, you know, discard or whatever seem to be that not giving them the information that I have access to Wasteland. So 6 one way, half dozen the other doesn't seem like a particularly big advantage no matter what I do, but I feel like this is slightly better. Mountain. Basic mountain. Okay. Stregerino. We missed. It's unfortunate. Alright, I guess we're gonna loam then. With a Thespian Stage out, it's better just to loam every turn because we can just hit Dark Depths. In general, with this deck, it's also just better just to loam every turn unless you have a specific reason to draw something. Because it's like you're drawing three cards a turn. Alright, are we gonna get Blood Moon here? Oh, Blood Sunned. Well, that's actually pretty annoying. Huh. All lands lose all abilities except mana abilities. I guess I'm not loaming. It doesn't really behoove me to loam. Sure, so... I can't Thespian Stage and I can't waste things. I can buy back Punishing Fire. I feel like I'm super dead. Turn 2 Blood Sun is annoying, I will give you that. This is the matchup where Crozen Grip comes in. And Sneak Attack. Okay, that is enough for me. Well, that is unfortunate. Let's put in some Crozen Grips. Kind of want Tireless Trackers too. Punishing Fire is out. Bojuka Bog out. I'm not in love with Glacial Chasm here either. Could put in like Sphere of Resistance or something. That seems pretty bad. Molten Vortex, I guess, is a way to get around that nonsense. Also, if they have Blood Moon, it does something. Do I want to take out one of these lands? I guess I don't love the idea, but I could take out a land. I mean, Tabernacle might just be bad. Seems like it's not. There's not. They don't have very many creatures. They're going to sneak out creatures or breach creatures a lot of the time. This is like, you know, Inferno Titan through the breach sneak attack sort of nonsense. And it's hard for me to kill all their lands. So I think I'm going to try this. All right. I like to play first. Yeah, I'm going to keep this hand. It has a lot of the things I want. It's missing a Gamble or a Life from the Loam. But it's got basically everything else. Let's go Mox Diamond. Discard Ghost Quarter. And I'm going to cycle Tranquil Thicket. And play a Thespian Stage. And I guess pass. I don't really need to play another Mox Diamond. I'm likely going to end up wanting to do so, but feels unnecessary. Lotus Petal. What are we casting here? Didn't have a 2-mana land, so they might not have anything else. They might also just have Desperate Ritual or something. Simeon Spirit Guide. Gotcha. Into Blood Moon. Well, Blood Moon I don't care about at all. I mean, I've got a basic forest, which I'm just going to play. I don't really need to do anything else. I could Crozen Grip it, but there's no real reason for me to do that. A Braid. Sure. Still don't really need to Crows and Grip the Blood Moon. Ooh, gamble. I like gamble. No gamble, no future. All right. Actually do want to play Thespian Stage this time. Because if I discard Loma, I'll be able to cast it this turn. I didn't mean discard Loam. If I discard, not Loam. Alright. That's Dredge, Loam. Life from Loam back, Dark Depths, Tranquil Thicket, Ghost Quarter. And let's play Dark Depths, and we'll play Mox Diamond, discarding Ghost Quarter. And end of turn, we're going to blow up the Blood Moon. And then we're going to make a 20-20, and we're going to win. Yoink. Oh. That is awesome. I did not realize that's how that worked, but it got no counters because it came into play under a Blood Moon, and then when I blew up the Blood Moon, the thing came in. Oh my god, that's incredible. Anyways, I don't really want Sphere of Resistance or Trinisphere. Definitely not Trinisphere. I think Sphere of Resistance sounds just kind of sucky. I could put an Ancient Tomb. That sounds bad too. I guess I could put in Mana Bond instead. Maybe Ancient Tomb will be a little bit better than Mana Bond. All right. When I sign a lot of spells, I'm just less inclined to want Mana Bond in my deck. Yeah, this hand has all the cards I want. As long as I don't get turn one Blood Mooned, I can Verdant Catacombs for a forest. And I have a Maids of Ith in case my opponent plays like some sort of ungodly combination of rituals into Inferno Titan. So, yeah. Of course, if they have turn one Blood Sun, that's also very annoying, but I just hope those things don't happen, I guess. No, City of Traitors. All right. We're drawing to six cards, Mox Diamonds and Forests. Oh, that's a Mox Diamond, no big deal. Definitely not playing the Mox Diamond yet, because I don't want to get abraded. And let's see. Oh, this is a turn two Dark Depths, of course. taste it. That was just so good. The fact that Blood Moon and Dark Depths combo that way is just amazing. Abrade, yeah. Yeah, I got bad news for you, my friend. I just can't get over that. This is just too good. All right, let's get in there. And all right, one more match since I want to finish this out because we're 4-0 in the league. And let's see if we can take it down. Alrighty, time for our final round here. I would like to play first. Yeah, I'm into this. We've got some action. We've got Forest, Exploration, Horizon Canopy, Mox Diamond. Actually, maybe I should have discarded Forest and kept Grove of the Bernalos. I suppose that would have been slightly better. But we get to turn one, cycle Canopy away. We're just looking, oof, that's not what I want. We're just looking for Gamble or Life from the Loam. Oh, there's a Gamble. Okay, let's hope. I'm gonna play Thespian Stage. I really don't wanna get Spell Pierced here. Don't care too much if I discard Loam, and hopefully my opponent does not have, I don't wanna get Flusterstormed either, I suppose, if people, so Maniac has main deck Flusterstorm. Hope my opponent does not Force of Will. Looks like they're going to brainstorm to find a Force of Will, if I had to guess. And there's the brainstorm. And if they don't have Force of Will, then we are in great shape. One of the reasons I do like lands is it does beat up on blue decks fairly nicely. All right, gamble, no gamble, no future. No, they have the Force. All right, they pitched Predict, so we're playing as Miracles, it looks like. Well, don't have tons of time. I also could just find Dark Depths, or I could just find Life from the Loam. I suppose that is also an option. All right. Better lucky than good, as they say. Play my lands, and I'm going to cycle Horizon Canopy, but I'm just going to do it end of turn, I think. I mean, I guess I could do it now, but... Ooh, my opponent's going to get some value off of Predict. They're going to, I think, successfully name... Scalding Tarn? Wow, lucky. I guess the only thing I could hit that I could even play with Horizon Canopy is like Exploration or Mana Bond. Or I could hit Crop Rotation or Gamble, I suppose. I could hit a lot of cards, but I'm not really interested in playing most of those cards right now. Counterbalance, okay. Well, the thing is they don't have a Sensei's Top, so... And currently they don't know the top of their library. I'm just gonna Dredge Loam. In case I hit a second Loam to also dredge. Let's loam back these things, shall we? They revealed Flooded Strand. That does not do the trick. Play Horizon Canopy, play Grove of the Burn Willows. And here I'm actually going to dredge Loam and just do this right away. Glacial Chasm. Alright. Horizon Canopy is not the best way to cycle, but with an Exploration in play, it still does a pretty good approximation of such. And opponent's going to get multiple bites of the apple this next turn with a Flooded Strand in play. Portent. Targeting themselves. So this is basically slow ponder, but because it's next upkeep, you can set up miracles quite nicely. And... they did not shuffle. So the question is, do I even want to dredge Loam? There's a good chance they just counter it here. I'm not really doing much. Sure. Oh, I did sure, and then I just hit cancel. Okay, well, that wasn't really what I intended. Let's sack Horizon Canopy. Actually, you know what? Let's actually just continue drawing. I feel like we're gonna get loamed out. All right, let's just play this, or counterbalanced out. Pass the turn. They didn't do anything, they didn't crack their fetch. I'm gonna Punishing Fire them end of turn. Okay, they are cracking their fetch now. These decks tend to have a lot of basics. All right, they portend themselves. I do get a little sneak peek. Like I get to Punishing Fire them end of turn and see what they're up to here. Okay. I mean, they're probably, even if they have a two, they don't want to reveal it here. Oh, they revealed Ponder? Okay. But didn't they know? Oh, I see. Oh, actually, that means they definitely have a two on top because they're drawing Ponder off of their thing. Actually, I'm going to sack Wasteland on their Flooded Strand. I don't want them drawing Ponder. And... they have a two under Ponder. They revealed thinking they were going to show me a two, but it was actually under Ponder. All right, so now I just got them to shuffle. I'm going to dredge Loam. And we're going to hope they don't end up drawing here. Or revealing a two here. Ghost Quarter, Wasteland, Horizon Canopy. And before they reveal a two, they revealed another Ponder. Okay. Definitely playing Horizon Canopy, and I'm going to play Ghost Quarter. And I'm going to pass... Actually, I'm not going to pass the turn. I'm going to dredge the Loam now. And we hit Dark Depths. Okay. That is what I wanted to see. Leave up Ghost Quarter. Now that I'm getting back dark depths, they might force of will me or something. That's okay. I can live with that. Basically, Life and Loam taxes their counterbalance pretty badly. Like, they're not going to be able, until they land Jace the Mind Sculptor, they're not going to be able to put a 2 down reliably here. I could also end up in a spot here. Okay, they have counterspell, sure. Where, so they're gonna ponder. I could end up in a spot here where if they have like a Jace out and they're floating a 2, I can start casting Punishing Fire and buying it back during odd play, odd times. They chose not to shuffle. Kidoki. Okay, they're gonna brainstorm. They're gonna leave a 2 on top because they have to. So I get to Ghost Quarter them. And actually I get to Wasteland them. Let's dredge Loam. Play a Wasteland. Wasteland the Flooded Strand. Okay, they let it happen. Ghost Quarter of the Plains. And they chose not to shuffle. And then I guess I'm gonna play Misty Rainforest and pass the turn, since I know that I would be extremely surprised if there wasn't a 2 on top. So opponent draws a 2. I'm gonna activate Jace. I'm gonna Punishing Fire you in response. Unless they have 2s. Okay, they have Snapcaster Mage there. All right, so they have 2s all the way down. So if they have a 2... So they have to have a 2 afterwards as well. That's unfortunate. So now I'm in a spot where I just have to draw Dark Depths, I guess. Because I'm locked out of Loam at this point. Ghost Quarter is interesting. Okay, well, I get to Ghost Quarter their Search for Ezkanta, I suppose. Past the turn. I suppose I could have gotten Punishing Fire back. Ooh, if they flip Search, I could also copy it with a Thespian Stage. So they're presumably not going to do that. So I could Ghost Quarter them a bunch here, but I don't really see what that does. Like, I think I'm just going to try to draw Dark Depths here. Instead, I keep drawing Ghost Quarters. I'll play the Maze of Ith because why not? I suppose I can try casting Punishing Fire again. There's no real downside to that. It's kind of brutal. They just have a 2 on top of their deck at all times. All right, they revealed Counterbalance. And yeah, sure, I'll get Punishing Fire back. Why not? So after this resolves, they have a 2, and then they have 2s all the way down, so it's going to be pretty hard for me to knock them off of having that. Then they're eventually going to get me with Entreat the Angels or something like that. I suppose I could Ghost Quarter their Tundras or something. I mean, they can't shuffle off Ghost Quarter, so... Ponder. Okay. Presumably they have a 2 there. They chose to shuffle? What in the world? Okay. Thought we were done here, but I guess not. Okay. I guess I got punished for not having. Oh, brainstorm. Okay. Sure. Well, they might not have all twos. I mean, they're gonna have a two here. Real snapcaster. Sure, sure. Let's just draw. Grove of the Burn Willows. Let's play the Grove. Let's get back Punishing Fires. Why did they ponder? That's interesting. I guess it's probably worth ghost quartering their Tundra here. Sure, that'll flow blue, that's fine. I'm probably not doing anything else here. I assume they're not gonna search. And don't think that I'm supposed to. Yeah, they're gonna snapcaster, okay. What are they snapcastering? Brainstorm, okay. Pass the turn. They get to Snapper, you know, they get to Brainstorm. I know their top card is a 2-drop. After their Brainstorm, I assume it's still a 2-drop. But I guess I could find out. No, I. I mean, I can just keep casting Punishing Fires. Giving them life doesn't matter. All right, they reveal another Snapcaster, sure. Now they're gonna Jace, and I guess I Punishing Fire here as well. And reveal Counterbalance, okay. So, at some point I can play Glacial Chasm. No, they can just Jace. But the thing is, they can plus try to start plus 2-ing Jace, but they run out of 2s at the top on the top of their deck at that point. Alright, they could attack me, I suppose, but oh, come on. Come on. Let's end of turn get back Punishing Fires. Or get back a Punishing Fire. The thing is, even if I draw Dark Depths, there's a good chance that they have Swords to Plowshares. Though Crop Rotation was a good draw. Crop Rotation gets me the Dark Depths as well. So there's a chance that I can like ninja them depending on you know, when things happen. All right. What would be great is if they flipped as Kanta and I got to copy with Thespian Stage and just start going off with using Mox Diamond for blue. How many Wastelands do I have left? 2 Wastelands and no Ghost Quarters. Okay. Counterbalance is annoying. At least since his Divining Top is gone. But yeah, Counterbalance is not the most fun card in the world to play against, not gonna lie. You know, given that they're lower on time, I'm curious as to why they're attacking the Snapcaster. Mm-hmm. Do you have to discard? Oh, funny. Loam doesn't do much. No reason to play Glacial Chasm. If it feels like they're setting up Entreat, maybe I do that, but don't need to do it right now. Come on, can't you find it's gone to just once? I don't think there's a possibility of me decking my opponent, but I guess I don't know. Oh, we're gonna Entreat now? Okay, I like that. Because now they don't know the top of their deck. And I have Glacial Chasm. All right, I'm gonna let the Entreat resolve. I want them to pay some stuff. They're just tapping out for Entreat. Okay. Well, let's try to nail this here. I mean, I have a Tabernacle out too. If this isn't a two, then I get to kill Jace. They revealed Terminus. Okay. Yeah, let's Punishing Fire you again. Okay, so Jace down. Now we're starting to get interesting, and I get to Punishing Fire again. Okay, so now they get to Jace. Six angels, so I get to make, I can make three Mazes of Ith with Thespian Stage. And they have to pay six mana. Can also just Glacial Chasm here. So I could Crop Rotation for Depths. I guess that's probably worth doing. And I'm just gonna sack the forest. And they can Force of Will here, but they didn't Force of Will my Punishing Fires. Okay, they're Force of Willing Pitching Search for Esconta. Okay, so they have, I mean, they have a two on top, like, we know that. Just untap. Just draw. Let's just play Glacial Chasm. Sack a Grove of the Burn Willows. And pass the turn. And then we're just going to try to outlast the counterbalance a few turns here. And then start casting these loams and just loaming over and over again. I mean, I assume they put two twos back. It would be pretty hard to imagine they did not. Prevent all damage that would be dealt to you. Yeah, and I'm going to get all my Punishing Fires back. I can also Punishing Fire, start Punishing Fire. Well, I guess it's unlikely that my... This game's really interesting. It's unlikely that my opponent is... let's Punishing Fire resolve here. I think there's a two on top. But they probably don't have double Force of Will, or they wouldn't have let Jace go, is my guess. If I can get them in a situation where they're having to hard counter Life from the Loam, then I'm probably going to win. I have three Loams in my hand. All right, so let's tap this for red. You know, I guess I could... Yeah, I'm going to throw a Punishing Fire at my opponent. Just to test the waters here. They revealed Swords to Plowshare, so they didn't have two twos to get back? Oh, It is open season. All right, yes, and we're not making a Dark Depths creature. We are gonna pay 2 life. We're gonna dredge Loam. Loam back, ghost quarter. Wait, no. Cancel. Loam back, wasteland, ghost quarter. So they have to have Brainstorm here. Okay. Even though they did get a 2-for-1, this is still essentially just a 1-for-1. So now I just pass. They have to pay a bunch of mana to their angels. I could also ghost quarter them. Let's see, so if I ghost quarter, I could actually Thespian Stage into ghost quarter and then ghost quarter them twice here if I want to. Huh. I could angel start a flooded strand also. Yeah, let's just wait on that. I could also start using punishing fire to pick off the angels. Well, it seems better than doing nothing, I think. Counter, okay, they revealed counterbalance. Oh, I'm supposed to get punishing fire back. That's all right. I'd like to pay 4 life. I would not like to dredge. Play Verdant Catacomb, pass the turn. All right, they get to do all this. And end of turn, I'm probably gonna start using Punishing Fire on the Angels again. So what I think my opponent really needed to do to have the best chance of winning this game is set up Entreat at the end of my turn with like a Brainstorm or something. Because now they were in a spot where I could just play Glacial Chasm and be able to get out of this. Also, I'm suspicious that all of my opponent's fetch lands have targets here. Okay, they revealed Force of Will. I don't just get to summon it back without saying anything. All right, yes. All right, angel down, and I'll go to 12. Get another Taiga. And get another Taiga. Or get another Punishing Fire back, rather. No. I would like to pay 6 life. I'm not going to loam back here. Cast Life from the Loam, and we're gonna get back Wasteland, Ghost Quarter. And what I can do now is end of turn. Also, are they almost out of Brainstorms here? Yeah, they've gotta be. Oh, Snapcaster. Sure. End of turn Thespian Stage the Glacial Chasm and let the first chasm go. And I can gamble, but I don't even know what gambling gets me at this point. The real counterbalance. I mean, getting a Dark Depths just doesn't do a whole lot. Hold on. What can I get that is good? So if we take a look at our deck, Caracas doesn't do a whole lot, and There's Tranquil Thicket or anything like that. Mazavith, Bojukabog. No, I don't think so. So let's... Nope. That's me losing somewhere else. I'm at 6. Yeah, that's just past the turn, I suppose. And killing their lands with Dark Depth or with Ghost Quarter doesn't seem like it accomplishes a whole lot either. So if you wanted a grindy game, I've got a deal for you. So what I'm likely going to do here is gun down another angel with Punishing Fire, and yeah, I can double Punishing Fire. Oh no, I guess I don't even have enough mana to double Punishing Fire. I guess I can untap and upkeep Thespian Stage of the Glacial Chasm, sure. That does work. Oh, they already discarded. I F6'd. So let's copy Glacial Chasm. Glacial Chasm goes away. Not drawing off Loam. Wasteland's not horrendous. Past the turn, I feel like my opponent put back 2/2, so I really want to wait an additional turn here. Whoa, what is going on there? Some action. and then now I get to double punishing. I guess, you know, double punishing firing the angels doesn't really do much. I feel like... Huh. Is there a way to do something sweet here? You can... I'm wondering actually if there is. I can glacial copy this chasm. So I guess yeah, let's just run this. There's just no reason not to. Real brainstorm. I don't like that they have a brainstorm there. I guess I only have 18 cards left, technically. And sure, I'll get my things back. So, or get a thing back. I keep thinking I can get all of them back for one. That is not how that works. So I can... Oh, what is this? Are you casting like Predict or something? Oh, Snapcaster Mage. On brainstorm, sure. Wait, now they're gonna brainstorm? Okay. I guess maybe Bojukabog to get these brainstorms out of their bin were a thing. All right, well. Anyway, so I can pay 2 life off this chasm, that's fine. Question is, what do I, so can I then copy this? I guess there's no... Wait, I feel like there's a way out of this. Let me see if I can put this... I'm like trying to derive this from first principles. Can I... No, I guess there's really no way to do exactly what I want. So what I want to do here is copy Glacial Chasm with Thespian Stage and then use this, turn this stage into something else so the Cumulative Upkeep doesn't go down. So I guess what I should have done was many turns ago, wow, the people who play lands, all 6 of you, are probably yelling at me the whole time, because what I should have done is just keep bouncing around which are chasms. Oh, I guess it doesn't help that much because the counter stays on the card. This is confusing. So basically when I had a Glacial Chasm out, I could have, and had like a bunch of age counters on it, I could have copied it earlier to kind of reset the age counters. Because then if I turn this into something that isn't a Glacial Chasm, it doesn't matter that it has age counters on it. Yeah, that is bizarre. All right. Like, what I can do, if I kill all the angels and then... and then copy a bunch of mazes of Ith, I can end up in a spot where I can then prevent... so the revealed counterbalance, sure. Oh, I wanted to turn this Thespian stage into something else. That was bad, yeah. Because I wanted to actually turn this into a Maze of Ith. Because this now... turning this into Maze of Ith doesn't really help me, right? Because then... Alright. And I drew another Thespian stage. So the dance continues. So they have... ooh, I'm actually... being down a maze here might actually be the difference. Because now I can... they have to have five creatures and I can kill... if I kill a couple of them... Whoa. Then... yeah, I should just have a maze with an age counter on it. Dear Lord, this is confusing. If I then had that, and because I can kill an angel and a snapcaster here, and then I'd be in the clear. I might actually still be in the clear. We'll see. Now snapcaster is down. So what my opponent doesn't know is if I kill all these angels, all of a sudden I can just end up with a bunch of mazes of Ith in play. So presumably they're casting this because they don't have a 2 on top. They revealed Jace the Mind Sculptor, okay. And... then I let them have that, and then end of turn, I turn both my Thespian stages into Mazes of Ith. Chooses to not shuffle. Okay, so... so I think this works. And Thespian stage becomes a Maze of Ith. And then now I have three mazes out, and they have three angels. Yeah. Sheltered Thicket. Sure, let's cycle that. Actually, let's not cycle that. We might get up to some Punishing Fire shenanigans here. All right. Yeah, so what I wanted to do earlier was a little bit more nonsense with Thespian Stage. I shouldn't have, first of all, I shouldn't have lost that first Thespian stage, and second of all, I might have been able to skate by with a Glacial Chasm with fewer counters on it. Some good practice. Ah, well done, my opponent said. That was game one. No big deal. I want Crows and Grips, I want Tireless Trackers, and I think I want Ancient Tomb. Molten Vortex also seems, actually, Molten Vortex seems like, if I have Life Malone going, I'm pretty happy. I don't think I want zero Punishing Fires, but it's not actually that good. Actually, maybe I want zero Punishing Fires, never mind. I don't really want Bojuka Bog. I'll keep the Glacial Chasm. Caracas seems just like a colorless land, so I think it's worse than all the rest of them. All right. Let's get in there. Alrighty, time for game two. I'm going to keep this hand. This hand is ready to life from the loam. There's a cruising grip, okay. I don't really want to discard a Mox Diamond. Basically, I want to gamble, and I don't want to discard Mox Diamond or Crozen Grip, but it's so much worse to discard Crozen Grip, I'm thinking about just gambling instead. So I think I'm just going to gamble like this. And obviously it might not resolve anyway. Okay, here's Loam. All right, and I don't really need to play the Mox Diamond this turn, but I'm glad I did not discard anything too critical. Search for Ezcanta. Well, I don't like Search for Ezcanta, but I don't care that much because I can blow it up. It's actually kind of funny how that works. Discard. Discard Thespian Stage. And I could use Ghost Quarter here, but I don't think that's worth it. I would rather just make my land drop. And I'll play Horizon Canopy. Unfortunately, not going to draw Exploration anytime soon because I'm going to be dredging Loam here. Opponent kept a card on top with a Search for Ezcanta. It might have been the mana source they were looking for a counterbalance. A Surgical Extraction by Loams. All right, that's like... not great for me, not gonna lie. Don't really have a way to stop that. Got a bunch of Thespian Stage though. Let's draw a card and pass the turn. So I'm looking for Tireless Tracker. That seems like it would be pretty sweet right now. Brainstorm Fetchland, a classic combination. It's actually kind of funny that I would disenchant my Mox. Sure, that doesn't do a whole lot for me right now anyway. But to play against Wasteland, you want to get basics, but playing against Ghost Quarter is almost the opposite, because the more basics you fetch out, the sooner Ghost Quarter starts becoming Strip Mine. Though my opponent's playing a deck that has millions of basics, so I don't think that's too much of an issue. I actually think I just get Dark Depths here. Alright, discarded Verdant Catacombs. Nice, nice, nice. Let's play Ghost Quarter. Pass the turn. Could get Tireless Tracker, but if I get Dark Depths out, there's a chance I just snipe my opponent here. No, predict, and they get to draw two. Get their Snapcaster Mage out of here. Basically, the way they play around Dark Depths Thespian Stage here is Swords to Plowshares and Monastery Mentor. Okay. That's unfortunate. And with a Ghost Quarter out, I might be able to Ghost Quarter them such that they don't have white mana, though. I know they have at least two planes, so it's going to be kind of hard. Exploration. Exploration is actually fine to play, I think. If I had that out last turn, might have been able to double Ghost Quarter and get that going, but... and of course, they do have to leave some number of Swords to Plowshares in, but they might not have infinite of them. So... maybe they trim like one or something, and maybe they just don't have one. Yeah, that's it. That's my story and I'm sticking to it. Let's see. Brainstorm, sure. I mean, they're going to want to attack with their mentor no matter what. So, I also don't really want to make a Dark Depths token while they can Jace Brainstorm it, or Jace Bounce it, rather. So unless they tap down and then attack, I'm probably just going to take whatever the hit is here, 5 or 7. Well, we might actually not be in a position to do that. Now I think we're just going to have to go for the block, and if they have a disenchant, or disenchant, they just had disenchant. If they have Source to Plowshares, then, well, too bad, so sad. I'll keep this one. What? I get to declare blockers? That feels like just my opponent not having the right stops. All right. Ooh, this is where not having exploration in play is unfortunate, because I would be able to play both my lands. All right, I'm going to play the Thespian Stage. And I guess I Ghost Quarter the Ascanta. They have so many basics in their deck. This is where I wish I had like a choke or something. Also, my opponent can't possibly finish game three, which, I don't know, we played a long game. A long match. There wasn't any sort of timing out shenanigans going. I'm playing as fast as I can. And I don't know that I'm... Am I literally dead here? I guess I'm taking 16 down to 20. I'm not literally dead. Like, if I draw Dark Depths or something, then I could see getting there. All right, I did not, so... Let's try game three. Do I want to keep Punishing Fire in for Monastery Mentor? That is the question. Thing is, like, Tabernacle does such a good job of that. I will take out one of the mazes, I guess. We don't want all the Punishing Fires. Still do like Ancient Tomb, I believe. I'll take out one Wasteland. All right. Like to play first. All right, I will keep this hand. This hand does some things. I'm not sure what exactly. I don't think I play Ghost Quarter. If I draw a land, I guess I have turn two Dark Depths. Any land, too, because of the Mox Diamond. Oh, actually, I have turned two Dark Depths. Do I have it no matter what? All right, well, I have that land, so... I can go get my Thespian Stage here. I'm not going to, though, I don't think. The fact that I have to crop rotate for it seems it makes it a little sketchy. Oh. Well, that's intriguing. Now I'm going to crop rotate for it. Okay, my opponent just let it resolve, so I'm just going to get Thespian Stage. And I guess I loam? No, I don't even know that I want to loam here. Because I can just leave up Dark Depths. I think that's better. They get to predict and draw some things. Predict is not great when you're running out of time. and I get to make a Dark Depths token end of turn. And then... thing is... the reason I went for the crop rotation there was that even if it fails, I've got a life in the loam now, and they don't have a counterbalance, and they don't have time to play a counterbalance, so it's going to be really hard for them to win this game. Sure. Like, I actually think I'm winning this game currently, even if my opponent wasn't running out of time, but they are running out of time, so... there's going to be hard for them to... All right, and there we go. Woo, we 5-0 the league. Got a bunch of loot. Went 4-0 in the matches here, and you got your money's worth. That was a long match. This deck is sweet. I'm going to continue playing it. I don't know if I want to make too many changes yet, but because the deck seems pretty well-tuned at this point. But, yeah, I always lose to lands, so I figured can't beat them, join them. Well, I've got plenty of more videos coming up, and we've got plenty of other talented content producers. So make sure to check us out here at ChannelFireball.com. We got the latest and greatest in content, free strategy, and all sorts of things. Legacy, standard, modern, vintage, pauper, and more. So ChannelFireball.com, and we've got our YouTube page at ChannelFireball. So check us out, and we'll keep it coming. Thanks for watching.